these value, this value to our core service and really moved up market. And we were really able to then get more and more dollars, incremental dollars per installation, but really raise the level of competence. What it also meant is that our margins are, and obviously our prices increased, but our margins are really. The second way of adding value is sort of surrounding your core. So when you go out and you ask your associates, and you can do this at your own company, and you ask them, what's the customer's perception of value? What's it based on? And you know, and they'll say, well, the customer's buying from us, and their perception of value is primarily about the core. And the other stuff we do, the ancillary stuff, the add-on stuff around the core, is good, but it's a small portion of their decision to buy. But when you go and ask customers, typically what they'll tell you is the core is important, but I'm paying you to do that. Whatever this is, you know, I'm paying you. You know, you have an obligation to get that installed properly. And what we're really interested in is finding out, you know, what are these other value-added services that you do to surround your product or service. And we've done lots and lots of surveys, and what's really amazing is that we go out and survey customers, we survey customers or competitors, other prospects in the marketplace, and you ask the question, what's the decision criteria for what we do? And they'll give you a list of answers, and it goes like this. Forever. And so you know, the interesting thing is and when you ask a salesperson why didn't somebody buy from you, what's typically their answer? There's two. Price. Absolutely. You ask a sales guy, why did you lose that deal? It's because the other guy was cheap, right? And what's the second reason? Because the customer's on the take. Those are the two reasons you get. Well, typically, this is answer number three and four.